I don't have a lot of battery left in my camera right now, but I really wanted to talk to you today about Coca-Cola. I've talked before about how I have this relationship with Coca-Cola where I like it a lot and would prefer that it didn't exist. Like, if there was a world without Coca-Cola, only good things would be different. Like, things would be only better. Except for the people who work at Coca-Cola, I'm sorry you lost your jobs. It's bad, and it's very easy to drink a lot of it, especially when you have a nice salty potato crisps of some sort. Just fried potatoes, and this have not led to good outcomes for America. But recently, I just noticed this for the very first time. I didn't know it was a thing that was going to happen, but it happened. If we zoom on in here to this Coca-Cola can and then focus real good, can you see it? Can you see where it says that it's added sugar 78%? I don't know if you can. Whatever. You know what I'm talking about. So it says total carb, 39 grams, 14% of your carbs. That's what it says. Total sugar is 39 grams, including 39 grams added sugars, 78%. What's happening here? Let's go thing by thing. First of all, one, the Food and Drug Administration makes them put this label on here, and they tell them what has to be on the label. It, when that first happened, they also had the recommended daily amounts of all the things, and they said, we want you to have the three main food types. Well, I guess only the two. Fat and carbs. Protein is, I think, elective. Like, you don't have to put protein on there, or you didn't used to. Maybe you do now, but it used to be fat and carbs and sodium, because those were the things people were concerned about. Now, to be clear, sodium, it turns out, isn't that big of a deal. You can watch Aaron Carroll on Healthcare Triage talk about why sodium isn't that big of a deal. But fat and carbs are a good thing to know. The crazy thing is that for so long, we put every carb in the same category. We said if you were eating, you know, a Triscuit, that was the same as eating a sugar cube. Because it's all carbs. Turns out it's not all carbs. Our bodies respond differently to different types of carbohydrates, especially when we're dealing with the difference between like simple carbohydrates and complex carbohydrates. You can tell the difference between those because one is like, oh, pasta, and one is like, this is the sugar, this is candy. Recently, they did this thing where they added, and I'm ambivalent about this. I'm excited and also a little bit upset about it. They added something called added sugars. And there's a certain percentage of what you need for, like, allowed a good amount of added sugars for the day. And this contains 78% of that. So if you have two of these, that's more than you should be having. And yes, I completely agree. That's the case. And I shouldn't be having any of these at all because it's terrible for you. It's candy water. Stop making me drink you. But the thing that I don't like about this is that it's added sugars. What does that mean? So total sugar is 39 grams. Total added sugars is 39 grams. What's the difference between sugars and added sugars? How would there be sugar in a Coca-Cola if it weren't an added sugar? Some of you have probably got it by now. Work on it a little harder. When is the sugar not an added sugar? When it's orange juice. So they wanted to say to the world that it, like, there is too much sugar in this and we should be drinking less of it than we do. And if you have two of them in a day, that's too much. If you have 1 liter, that's too much all on its own. That's like 130% of your daily added sugars. The idea that different sugars are better or worse because they're added versus there because they were made by a fruit is ludicrous, and we are reinforcing that idea because it seems right. It's like, oh, well, a Coke is obviously worse for you than a glass of orange juice. And maybe in some ways that's correct because orange juice maybe has some fiber in it, because orange juice has some other, like, various nutrients in it. But it's in terms of the sugar content, it's not. The fructose in orange juice is the exact same fructose as the fructose in Coke. There is not a difference. To be clear, we, in our brains, like, it seems much better to give a child apple juice than Sprite, but it's the same. It's chemically the same. Why, instead of saying sugars, 78%, because it says total sugars, 39 grams, total added sugars, 39 grams. Why do we divide those things into two different things? Here's why. Because the U.S. Food and Drug Administration is heavily influenced by the farmers and they don't like it's one thing to say like Coca-Cola, you have to deal with this because you are a company, a big company that makes plenty of money, versus like the people who run the orange groves. And those people are very different and harder to make rules that hurt. It's much easier to make a rule that hurts Coca-Cola than it is to make a rule that hurts a farmer. And so that's the difference. That's why we continue to not only sort of have this intrinsic sort of a bias toward more natural sources of sugar, but that bias is reinforced by laws, by the policies of the U.S. Food and Drug Administration to say that, and I know that it seems like I'm having a conspiracy theory here, but no, this is actually how it is. Like, this is the recognized reason why this is a thing, that they don't want to create laws that hurt farmers. And I also don't really want to create laws that hurt farmers. Farming is a terribly difficult job. But to be clear, the sugar in Coke also comes from farms. Where do you think it comes from? It comes from farms. It comes from farmers. Now, it doesn't come from orange grove farmers. It comes from sugar beet farmers, and it comes from corn farmers, mostly. Depends on the kind of Coke you're getting. But like, yeah, for Coca-Cola, you're talking about corn farmers, but they're farmers too, and their farm is also economically difficult to maintain. It is also a very hard job to have a corn farm. There will probably be people arguing with me in the comments that high fructose corn syrup is chemically different from and biologic, like it has different biological impacts than the sugar mix in apple juice or orange juice. I disagree with them. The science tends to disagree with them. Like, there doesn't seem to be a lot of indication that as long as you're dealing with these simple carbohydrates, it's kind of all the same thing. It's not the same when you're talking about like whole wheat pasta or bread versus a sugar cube. But when you're talking about sucrose and fructose and glucose and all that stuff, it seems to be roughly the same to our bodies, and in the way that it is all quite bad. And it's okay to have a certain amount of it, but the fact that it is added, that is the thing that we've used to distinguish it. It seems very faux to me. It seems like we found a way to have it impact Coke and not impact orange growers and apple growers. But I am glad that it exists because, frankly, we consume most of our sugar in sugary candy drinks like Coca-Cola, not in fruit juices. Because I think in part, well, one, I think they taste a little bit better. Two, they have caffeine, so they're a little more addictive. And three, they're cheaper. So I'm glad that it's there. I'm glad we're doing this. And I know that it was probably a huge fight. But it's so interesting that the compromise that was necessary to get it on this bottle or this can by making it added sugars instead of sugars. Share a Coke with a tailgater!